I love munching on these crunchy clusters. They're awesome, but not as awesome as a Raspberry Pi cluster. Stick around, because it's TechWiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I teach you technology through tutorials. Today, I'm going to teach you the easiest way to set up a Raspberry Pi cluster using the Bitscope Blade Rack. I reached out to the team over at Bitscope, and they were kind enough to send me out one of their Bitscope Blade Racks. It's a 19-inch 1RU rack mount server that includes the Bitscope Blade Quattro Pi and a 5-port network switch. It's the simplest and tidiest solution out there. So clusters are a set of connected computers that work together as a single system. So a set of four Raspberry Pi 3 devices would essentially act as a 16-core computer. Distributing the workload over 16 cores gives the cluster more processing power, the same way a supercomputer works. So without getting more technical, a cluster is just a large-scale computer with many CPU cores. The software is what makes clusters really tick, and is by far one of the things that is lacking out there on the YouTubes. Unfortunately, most software needs to be manually programmed in a language like Python and software like MPI for Pi. So MPI for Pi helps to distribute tasks across several Raspberry Pis or nodes. The nodes all work together to make the program task run faster. In future videos, I'll be teaching you how to set up a Boink cluster, which is searching for aliens and curing cancer, and a web server with the Bitscope Blade Rack. So make sure you've subscribed and have notifications turned on for those. The heart of the Bitscope Blade Rack is the Quatro Pi. This board is powered from a 9-volt 4-amp to 48-volt 500-milliamp external power supply with a 2.5mm jack. It gives each Raspberry Pi enough reliable power for USB-powered hard drives and other USB devices. You can also power down or reset each Raspberry Pi individually, which means you don't need to power down the whole Quatro Pi board. Instead, you can replace any Raspberry Pi without interrupting the other units. Each slot on the Quatro Pi board also has an auxiliary power header, which means you can power a Raspberry Pi display or other devices. If you need to use the HDMI port or audio port, these are accessible from the first Raspberry Pi slot. USB ports are accessible from the rear as well for all Raspberry Pis. You can find the Quatro Pi or Bitscope Blade Rack, which includes the Quatro Pi, directly from the Bitscope website. Link is in the description. Or you can source them from one of their reseller websites like Element 14. What's included with the Bitscope Blade Rack? We've got two panels for the enclosure, the front cover, and two ears for the rack. The Quatro Pi board, a 5-port network switch, four Ethernet cables, two pieces of double-sided tape for mounting the network switch inside the rack, four M3 metal standoffs, 16 M2.5 nylon standoffs, eight M4 screws, four 6mm M3 screws, six 10mm M3 screws, 32 M2.5 screws, four M3 CSK screws, four M3 washers for the 6mm M3 screws, and these awesome instructions with easy to follow pictures. Since I'm showing you, let's run through how easy it is to construct the Bitscope Blade Rack from start to finish. Installing the Raspberry Pis onto the Bitscope Blade Quattro Pi board is relatively simple. Using the 16 M2.5 nylon standoffs and the 32 M2.5 screws, place the nylon standoffs between the Quatro Pi board and the Raspberry Pis, and use the screws either side of the standoffs. Once you are done, it should look like this. Now, the Raspberry Pi standoffs stop the Raspberry Pis from moving around. If you don't use them, the Raspberry Pis could potentially touch the PCB, so don't skip this step. Using the four M3 washers and the four 6mm M3 screws, attach the four M3 metal standoffs to the Quatro Pi. If you wanted to power the Quatro Pi board via the mounting tabs at the blade edges, you will need to replace the metal standoffs with nylon standoffs yourself. Now we can attach the Quatro Pi board to one of the metal panels. So grab the four M3 CSK screws and attach the metal panel to the standoffs. It takes a little bit of time to line them upright, so take your time here. Once you're done, flip it back over and attach the double-sided tape to the bottom of the 5-port network switch, and then press the switch onto the metal panel. Remember to orient the ports to the same side as the Raspberry Pi Ethernet ports. This is important. Next, we will connect the Ethernet cables from each Raspberry Pi to the 5-port network switch. Initially, I got it all hooked up, but it wasn't very tidy, so I used one of the cable ties that came with the Ethernet cables. That looked a little bit tidier, but then I tried something different since the cables were flat. And after all that, it looks a little bit tidier again. To make things easier, plug in the power for the blade and the network switch before we go any further. And if you've got your micro SD cards prepared, put them in now too. Place the other metal panel on top now, and using the two ears and the 8M4 screws, connect the two panels together. Now it's starting to look more like a 1RU rack mount server. Lastly, using the 6 10mm M3 screws, attach the front cover to the metal panels, and then we are done. The Bitscope Blade Rack is constructed and ready to be powered on. So now we have the four Raspberry Pis enclosed and connected inside the Bitscope Blade Rack. How awesome does that look? Are you interested in cluster computers, specifically a Raspberry Pi cluster? Maybe you want to help fight cancer or search for aliens. Let me know down in the comments below. Did you enjoy this video and want to see more projects? Then subscribe to this channel now. If you are a subscriber, make sure you hit that bell icon so you are notified whenever I release a new video. Like this video and share it on Reddit and Facebook groups. And as always, imagine, learn, create.
The more you know.
A few moments later.